ASL1 Cologne, the 9th CSGO Major, begins tomorrow. And this is going to be my Group C preview, where I look at the matchups of all the teams, go into the map pools. And as ever, in the description box below, there will be a link to a storylines piece for Group C, looking at some of the different players that have key storylines or teams, and what the implications might be for them getting out of the group or not getting out. So in this video, we're talking about Group C. Group C is the one that has Team Liquid as the number one seed. They came obviously from a top four at MLG Columbus. Virtus Pro is the number two seed because they finished in the quarterfinals of MLG Columbus. Interestingly, both teams actually lost to Luminosity, the eventual champions. And the third seed is Mouse Sports, who failed to get out of the groups at MLG Columbus, but qualified as one of the top teams for this tournament. And the last seed, the number four seed, one of the hardest number four seeds in this tournament, is Envious. The champions two majors ago at DreamHack Cluj-Napoca, but they went out in last place at the last major, and then they actually had not even that convincing a qualification run at the qualifier for this one. So, actually, let me just double check something. Let me check something is right. Let me see. I just had to check. The problem actually for Envious, as well as to why it's a bit harsh that they are considered the fourth seed in this group, is that actually they were one of the better teams in the qualifier for ESL1 Cologne, but that Mouse Sports was one of the teams who were just one of the absolute top ones in the qualifier. So even among the number four seeds, Envious were kind of a bit hard done by because they didn't even do poorly in the qualifier. So this group is one where you got to look at it and go, it's not that sick a group. Like, you got VP and Envy, who obviously have the potential to go far, but haven't done it in a long time. Team Liquid got a different roster than it had with the last run, and not even their real roster. And Mouse Sports, perennial underachievers, but Nico's fantastic. So, okay, we look at the matchups here. Let's look at the teams before we do the matchups, so we can see the overall preview. So we'll start in order of seeds. So Team Liquid, it's key to remember that they have Simple and JDM in the lineup. They don't have Adren, who was at the last major. Simple was a full-time member at the last major, hasn't been a full-time member since then, only played Malmo with them, and then came back to the lineup now, played ECS with them. JDM's obviously a new recruit, only played at ECS with them, so the team lineup is pretty different than the last editions of Team Liquid, and actually that's represented in the maps that they've been playing. So it's very hard to know what their maps are, because they've only really played one LAN with this lineup, so we're just going to have to go off that alone, and then look at the picks and the bans there. So at the LAN that they played, their only wins came on Cobblestone, where they were actually able to beat G2 twice. They lost on Train to LG, they lost to now SK, they lost on Nuke to G2, and they lost on Dust2 to G2. They mainly banned Overpass and Cache, but they also then banned three other maps, just one instance each. So we look at them, we only know they're decent on Cobble. Train seemed all right against LG, the rest very much up in the air, so no one, including them, really knows their map pool, actually. So that's one of the big wild cards for this tournament. Then you come to Envious. Let me see, actually it should be VP next, because they're the number two seed. So go to VP. Obviously, classically, this is a team we know the strengths of. This is a team that was in a big slump earlier in the year, but they seem like they've come out of it a bit. Not to the extent that they're an elite team, which is where VP was. We're used to them being like a top four, top five team, but they're definitely in that sort of top six, top seven range at least, and they still are dangerous for even teams above them, and certainly can take care of kit tier two. So what's interesting about VP is that overwhelmingly, their Mirage is still god tier. They've won 10 out of the last 12 on LAN. They've won their last six in a row. They are always in double digits, even in losses. So Mirage, traditionally their best map, has actually returned to being their best map. And that's one map that has never betrayed them. Train, Cobble, and Overpass are other maps we associate with this team. And now what's interesting is they're all good maps for them, but they're all hovering around like 50% win rate on LAN over the last few months. None of them are really sick. And the problem they have here, mainly, is primarily the opponents that they play on these maps, because these are maps that in general people try to get away from unless they're specialists. So first of all, a lot of people aren't going to let VP play Mirage. That's why they have a gold like record there. Train, they've lost a bunch of times, mainly to the best train teams in the world. So you look at that and you go, okay, give you a bit of a break there. You're still fantastic on Train. Cobblestone, they've actually won their last four, so they've kind of turned that map around again. One of their best like a year ago, then it went away towards the end of the year. Now it's back again. That's very much back in the mix. And Overpass is still one of the best. They're still one of the best teams in the world on this map. Their record just doesn't look as good because they basically have lost their games on it to Luminosity, Na'Vi, and Astralis. In my opinion, three best teams in the world on that map. that. So you look at the fact they're always in double digits. I think Overpass is very good for them. In fact, I might even, if it wasn't for the fact they barely play it, just because of people not wanting to play it against them, I might even have that as their third map over Cobblestone, despite its resurgence. Then you go to, like, Cash is very middling. They tried a bit of Dust 2, even though it's their famous permaban, and actually it wasn't terrible, but they went back away from it. And Nuke is a map that they only played once. It was at E-League, and it was against Gambit. So we think of Dust 2 still their permaban, godlike at Mirage, and then good, certainly good and above average at Train and Overpass, and it just depends if they play world-class teams on that. And Cobblestone, still pretty solid. The rest of them, it's getting less good for them. So I think still a pretty good map pool for Virtus.pro. Famously, one of the best qualities they have is having a very good map pool. Now, if we go to Envious, this is a very interesting team, because we look, considering the team only when Kenny S and Apex joined, so that era of the team, they have three distinct sub-eras within it. So you have the Glory Days. Now, in the Glory Days, they were gods on Cobblestone, Cash, and Inferno. These three maps, they were godlike on. Then the rest of the map pool was actually kind of weak and very up and down, and they used to just win some of those maps against all odds by having godlike skills. So you have these three maps. Then you go to the Slump era, where they still had Kirishima. Now, interestingly, in this era, Cash remained very good. Mirage actually emerged as a decent map, despite classically not being a good map of the old team. And then they had Inferno, Train, and Cobble were okay. So Inferno and Cobble dropped down to just being okay, and Train actually became okay for them. Now you come to this era, the Devil era. Now in the Devil era, Cash remains very good map. So they're still good on Cash. That's a map that has never betrayed them. It's very reliable for them. But interestingly, the next two good maps for the team now is actually Dust 2, a map they were never good on in the Apex and Kenny S era, or the Slump era with Keo, but they were good on in the Shox era before that. That's become a good map for them again. Then you got to add into the mix, Cobblestone remains a good map for them, but they still have some issues on it. But here's what's interesting, is that they've won their last five instances of Cobblestone. So it's coming back to being a very strong map. So they're getting back to the days of Cobble and Cash as two of their very strong maps. But now they've got Dust 2 as well. So they've got a different look, but they've got some of the classic Envious within there of the Apex Kenny era, when they were champions, obviously, winning numerous events and making all the finals. So I think this is a very good sign coming into this tournament. Mirage is middling, they don't play it that often. Train, amazingly, they actually beat VP on E-League, but they don't play it very often. It's not a classical map for them, but they seem to have tweaked it and got Kenny S more effective, so maybe that can be a float map for them. And then they don't play Overpass, they famously ban it, and obviously they haven't played Nuke either. So their last team is Mouse Sports, and Mouse Sports are a team where they're famously, for me, the Guardians to Tier 1. If you beat them, you're probably Tier 1. If you lose to them, you're probably Tier 2. And they can't really properly break into Tier 1, they're just on that barrier. So this team, their best maps are far and away Dust 2. Interestingly, those Dust 2 and Cash. Interestingly, those two are classic maps for the old era that had God be on it. And also classic German maps. So I'm not surprised they're good on these two maps. They're still good on them now. And it goes with the core of this team back to the Penta days, really. So those are really their good maps. Beyond that, they've got a very weak map pool. Because you go to Mirage and Train. Like, they don't really want to play Train, but they've got wins on it. Mirage, they lose too much on it, but they always get double figures. So I feel like Mirage and Train are their middle ground. Cobble, they play a fuck ton of Cobble because of the way the map veto tends to work, but they're not a good team on it. I mean, true, they've lost to a number of the good teams on this map, but they just aren't good on it, and yet they're willing to let it play. And so I feel like Cobble's always the map that betrays them ultimately against the Tier 1 teams. Overpass, they're terrible on, and they don't play Nuke. So now that we know the strengths of the teams, now we have to look relative to the opponents they're going to play. So remember, the pick ban system is that the highest seed gets to pick to be Team A or Team B, because Team A gets three bans, Team B picks the side that you start on the maps. So I'm going to say again that I think the highest seed will always, and should always, in my opinion, pick Team A. Just because I don't think, personally, I don't care. I think it's psychological the side you start on, so I'd rather have map bans myself. So Team Liquid versus Envious is the first matchup. And obviously the key detail here is that Team Liquid are the higher seed because they finished top four at the last major. So if Team Liquid pick to be Team A, which they should, then I think they start out. And here's the key detail. If Team Liquid have done their homework and Peacemaker knows what the fuck he's doing, he should understand that in this group, he is going to potentially play against Mouse Sports and Envious. And Mouse Sports and Envious both ban Overpass as their permaban. So even though Team Liquid banned Overpass the most at ECS, they should float Overpass and let the opponent ban it and get a free ban themselves, essentially. And they've got three bans anyway. That's how they can manipulate this map pool. So I'm going to assume he's done his homework and he does this. Therefore, I think Team Liquid goes ahead and bans Cash, the second most banned map for them at ECS, and obviously a godlike map for the guys from Envious right now. So you've got to get Cash out of there. You get it out, first of all. I think then Envious bans Overpass, because Envious want it out of there, so they're willing to use one of their bans. Now, I think that Team Liquid at this point bans Dust 2 because they commented online that they'd rather play Train than Dust 2 when they had a choice. I think it was against G2. No, because Luminosity, I think. And interestingly enough, because obviously the old lineup with Simple actually liked Dust 2. So let's say they ban Dust 2 here because that's also emerged as an Envious map again. And you don't want to face Kenny S on it right now. I think the guys from Envious ban Nuke at this point. They just don't want it in there. And so I think with the last ban, that actually Team Liquid will pick to ban Mirage because it's not a map they've played. And it doesn't look like it's one that they necessarily want to go on. Meanwhile, it's an okay map for Envious. It's not a sick one. But the key detail is that would leave the randomizer picking between Train and Cobble. And I think for TL, these are maps they definitely don't mind playing. They want to play a bit of Cobble. I think they're Envious. They definitely want to play Cobble, and they don't mind playing Train because they won their last three land maps of it, and they just beat VP on it. So I think this is good for both teams, and I think actually Envious is going to win either of those maps. I think Envious is a better team right now and has everything covered, especially with the tweaks to Kenny S on Train. So I think actually Envious will win this matchup. The other matchup is Virtus Pro versus Mouse. Now, I think VP should pick to be Team A, especially because they've got this super sick map pool depth, and they know Mousebots don't have deep map pool map depth. So you know you can probably force them to the cobblestone, which they don't mind playing, but they nearly always lose, and that's exactly where you want to be if you're VP. So you look at it. I think VP does their classic ban. They ban Dust 2 because it's their perma ban, and it's the best ban, and it's the best map of Mouse. Obvious ban here. Therefore, I think over on the Mousebot side, you ban Overpass, your perma ban, but also a very good map for Virtus Pro and a classic Virtus Pro map. That leaves Virtus Pro in a situation where I think they just ban Nuke because it's not a map they really want to play. Didn't work out for them against Gambit. So I think they just ban out Nuke, even though admittedly Mouse doesn't play it, just because you've got the three bans here. I think Mousebot chooses at this point to ban Train, just because even though they've done better on Train than Cobblestone, or admittedly over a smaller sample size, they've shown more willingness to play Cobblestone. Therefore, I think they ban out Train because Train and Cobble are both very dangerous on VP's side, but Mouse seem to want to play Cobble more. They're more comfortable there. And personally, I think that the VP guys are more dangerous on Train if you're not a good Train team. So I think Mouse bans Train here. I think with the last ban, that VP just bans Cash at this point in time, which is obviously second strongest map for Mousebots, classic Mousebots map, not a map that VP's ever been that strong on. It's kind of at the lower end of their map pool, the last three maps. So I think they just get this out here, which leaves us with a randomizer between Cobble and Mirage, maps that Mousebots certainly don't mind playing, maps that VP want to play. Mirage is their best map. Cobblestone's a top three map for them, with won their last four on it. I think either of these come up, it's going to be a Virtus Pro win. Therefore, I have a winner's bracket final match of Envious versus Virtus Pro. I think in this scenario, Virtus Pro is the higher seed. They should pick to be Team A and try and exploit Envious and get an edge that they didn't get it in the E-League final. So here is what I think happens. I think Virtus Pro bans Dust 2, their permaban, because it's also been one that that Envious has started to show resurgence on. So you've got to stick with your permaban. Envious is going to do their classic overpass ban. It's their permaban anyway, and it's against VP, so you just get it out of there. VP at this point, I think, ban Cash because it's on the lower end for them. They know it's the best map in statistically for Envious, and they just lost to Envious on it at E-League. So I think they ban Cash. I think Envious bans Mirage because it's by far the best VP map, and it's a map Envious don't really want anyway. So I think with the final ban, that VP will ban Nuke, which will leave us with Cobble or Train for this randomizer. Now, Cobble or Train, both great maps for the guys from Virtus Pro. Cobble, obviously, a very good map for Envious, and they've looked improved on Train. So this should be a great match, actually. I think this will be one of the matches of the tournament in terms of, like, say it comes out Cobble, what a great game this could be. Could be one of the best single maps we have in the whole tournament. Thing is, I actually think that Envious will win either. I think if it comes Cobble, Envious will edge it. And I think I think Envious will win by a decent margin on Cobble, rather. And I think if it comes Train, Envious will just edge it because I like the tweaks they've done to set Kenny S up. Not only have they given great spots on CT and they're positioning him well outside, but on T side, they have him going in. It looks like they have him go in like third or fourth after other people have made big pushes into the site like Apex. So they're clearing out room and drawing attention. Then Kenny S is coming in and his flick shots are back on. And he's using that to just clean up that outside site with one or two kills. It's looking really effective. He just comes out of the main. So I think that could be very good. And now that could be the key, combined with the good CT holds we're now seeing from Envious, to actually win Train against VP, which you wouldn't have thought would happen a few months ago. But it looks possible right now. And the form looks like it's on Envious side. So I have Envious squeaking out there and winning the group. Then in the lower bracket final match, rather, we have Team Liquid versus Mouse. TL should have used the fact that they have the seed, picked to be Team A, which I think means that they start out with a ban of cash, because you know it's a fantastic map for Mouse. It's one that you've been banning. You haven't really shown any willingness to play. So I think you ban cash here. Mouse Sports will ban Overpass anyway, which actually, remember, if you floated it correctly, was one of your bans, but you can get them to ban it here because they definitely don't want to play it. I think Team Liquid bans Dust too, because as I said, they showed that they didn't really want to play it, and we know it's the best Mouse map. Then I think Mouse Sports bans Train, because again, as I said, they've shown a willingness to play Cobble, even though Cobble and Train are two that they don't tend to want to play, but they've got wins on Train, and yet prefer to play Cobble for whatever reason, so I think they actually ban Train here. I think with the last map ban, that Team Liquid probably bans Mirage, which means for this game matchup, we end up with Cobble or Nuke. Now, if it comes Nuke, God only knows. At that point in time, I really do not know what happens. I mean, I can see a world in which Mouse actually wins that one heavily, just based on individual skill, or just based on Nico go ham. I think that's the most variable one. Maybe Team Liquid probably can win that one. God only knows. I mean, it's Nuke, right? No one really knows. If it comes Cobble, though, I have to say, despite the fact that I'm not a believer in Mouse on this map, I don't think they're a good team on this map, I still think they can win this one, actually. I think they will slightly edge it. And so I have Mouse just edging Team Liquid, because I don't have a lot of faith in this random lineup of Team Liquid. So as a result, I think the decider, the best of three, ends up being VP versus Mouse. But obviously, it's a best of three now. So let's consider the ban phase before and how it might be different. So I think it'll still be the same initial bans, because these are two teams that permaban. VP will ban Dust 2, Mouse Sports will ban Overpass. So now we have to consider, what should the picks be in this scenario? So I actually think, in terms of the picks, that VP picks Mirage. But the question here is whether they want to do that or pick Train. Because it's Mirage or Train will be the picks for VP, but I noticed they tend to pick Train against teams they think are weak on Train. Now Mouse actually has some wins on Train, but they've shown that they don't really want to play it, so that's why VP at least should think about it. I still think they should go with Mirage, where even though Mouse Sports is okay in it, VP are gods on it. So I think VP picks Mirage, and I think Mouse Sports in this scenario, it has to be a cash pick, right? Because it's your second best map, D2's out of there already, you know VP can lose on it, so you got to pick cash here, which leaves the randomizer between Train, Cobble, and what would the third one be? And Nuke. So in this world, we'll just consider the first two maps, first of all. So we're going to have Mirage and Nuke at Cash, first two maps. I think definitely VP is winning Mirage. I think Cash, VP can also win it. I actually probably think VP would 2-1 this, 2-0 this series. But if somehow Mouse Sports wins Cash, then we think of the randomizer. If it comes Train, I think VP wins. If it comes Cobble, I think VP wins. If it comes Nuke, that's obviously a very difficult one. There's a lot of randomness can happen there. So we'll just say that's 50-50. So I think that VP wins 2-0. And if it goes to three maps, I think VP wins 2-1 regardless. So I don't think Mouse Sports is getting out of this. I think VP is coming out second, and I think this is the group. Now remember, if you want to see some storylines for this group, description box below, there's a link there to my gamers article where you'll be able to read my five or whatever number I picked storylines for this group.